In Stanley Kubrick's epic 2001, A Space Odyssey, the monolith is revered by a tribe of primitive apes. The monolith, as we would find out, is not what it appears. In The Paradise Syndrome, we'll also discover a monolith, in this case, an obelisk. It's not what it appears to be, and the primitive, though not prehistoric, society is greatly influenced by the presence of that structure. This is not to suggest that 2001 was in any way influenced by this Star Trek story. We aired near the end of 1968, and 2001 came out afterwards. But parallels can be interesting. Parts of this episode were shot on location, a rarity for Star Trek, especially during the budgetary crunch of our third and final season. It seemed as though the ship was sinking. Gene Roddenberry was busy producing a feature film, Pretty Maids All in a Row, starring Rock Hudson and Angie Dickinson. The series budget was now only $178,500 per episode, down from $187,500. Each episode was shot in only 5 days with, if you can imagine this, 30 camera setups a day, which, take it from me, is a lot. There was no support from the network, and morale, all-time low. It's a wonder any episode was ever completed at all. The original story outline and the final script for The Paradise Syndrome were vastly different. In the initial teleplay called The Pale Face, Kirk's amnesia was the result of a head wound. His memory was restored when he realized he was fighting against Spock. And Miramani, Kirok's, or Kirk's wife, survived. Just think, Kirk would actually have had a child long before the one we learned about in Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan. Imagine the possibilities. Kirk and offspring together on their mission throughout the galaxy. Do you think he would have let his kid steer the Enterprise? No.